Replicant, real name Anthony Gambi, made his first appearance in Flash Secret Files and Origins No. 2, published in 1999. The story, titled 21st Century Rogue, was written by Mark Waid and Brian Augustyn, and penciled by Ron Lim. In it, we meet Anthony Gambi, a guy who basically grew up with the Flash Rogues. Tony's mother died when he was very young, and his dad spent most of his time in prison. Thus, little Tony was sent to live with his uncle, Paul Gambi. Paul is of course the tailor who's known for supplying the Flash Rogues with their costumes. Hanging out in Paul's tailor shop during his formative years, Tony got to spend a lot of time with the Central City Rogues Gallery, including Captain Cold, the Trickster, Mirror Master, and so on. All the rogues liked Tony and treated him as their very own nephew. They even showed him how to use their various weapons and gadgets, for fun. The rogues were always there for Tony too, helping him out with bullies and other problems. As such, Anthony Gambi certainly had a very different view of the rogues than the rest of Central City had. He understood they were criminals, but he didn't see them as bad guys. He viewed them more as sort of Robin Hood figures. Besides Paul, they were his only family too. Flash forward several years, and the Dark Flash, a violent alternate Flash from another reality, battles the two captains in Keystone, Cold and Boomerang. Neither of these crooks know this Dark Flash is a phony. Like the rest of Keystone, they simply believe it's Wally West in a new costume. As such, they underestimate his talent for viciousness, and Captain Boomerang ends up severely burn damaged during the fight. Tony was a witness to it all from afar, and rushed to the scene, helping the captains make their escape. They later regroup in Paul's tailor shop, all present rogues shocked at the Flash's behavior. Naturally, they want vengeance, but none of them is powerful enough to beat the Scarlet Speedster. So they get an idea. They'll create the ultimate rogue, one with the powers of all of them combined. To do this, they call on their old friend, Tio Morrow, or Tomorrow. I've never gotten higher spells to say that. Anyway, using his grapple beam, Morrow steals from the future a device called the Humanifold. With this contraption, a human can be fused with technology, like for instance the rogue's signature weapons. This will thus create a composite rogue, one with all their powers. All they need, however, is a subject. Tony hates what the Flash did to Boomerang, and deep down he's always wanted to be a rogue himself. So he volunteers. The young man is then strapped to the Humanifold, and moments later he's reborn as the ultimate rogue, dubbed Replicant by Boomerang. As per their plan, Replicant then lure out the Dark Flash in the two fight. The rogues only intend this to be a trial run, however, but Replicant does pretty well for himself, giving the Speedster a run for his money. When the police arrived, Replicant even discovered he could absorb their weapons as well. In fact, he can absorb and use the power of any weapon. In the end, you could say the fight was a bit of a tie, as Tony made his leave before things got too hot. The character returned 1 month later though for a four-parter published across the Flash 155 to 158. In this story, he continues to go after the Dark Flash, still not realizing it's not actually Wally West. Replicant also seek out various other supervillains in Keystone, like the Angle Man, and absorb their gadgets in order to get even more powerful. Replicant is then summoned by Abracadabra, the mad magician from the future, and one of the Flash's deadliest foes. Kadabra is also after the Dark Flash, and it's actually because of him this alternate Flash came here. It's a really long story, and even the comic itself realizes how convoluted all of this is. But in short, the Dark Flash came here to kill Kadabra, and Kadabra is very well aware that this isn't Wally West. Anyway, so Kadabra figured he could use Replicant's help in this whole mess. In other words, supervillain team up. Of course they lost, as always, and Wally West finally returned. Yeah, he was missing, maybe I forgot to mention that. You try and find a Flash story that ain't confusing. I still love him though. Anyway, following this arc, Replicant showed up in a couple of tiny cameos, and that's all we've seen of the character. He hasn't appeared in anything else. It was about time I did another Flash Rogue, don't you think? The enemies of the Scarlet Speedster are, after all, one of the greatest rogues galleries of all time. So what can you really say about Anthony Gambi, aka Replicant? Personally, I hate these types of characters. Villains who combine the powers of an entire rogues gallery and becomes a sort of ultimate villain. So what? The rest of the rogues aren't necessary any longer? Is that what we're going with? Whenever a character like this shows up, I get the feeling that is what the creators are trying to say. Oh, look at me, I created a villain who's better than all the rest. In fact, who needs them now? This usually fails though, and these types of characters fade away, while the classics do stick around. Which is exactly what happened to old Tony. With that said, I don't hate Replicant. The character is imbued with a love for the Flash Rogues. This is a guy who doesn't believe he's better than the classic villains, as we saw Tony greatly admires them. And clearly so do the writers. I don't feel Replicant Replicant was created to replace the Flash villains. I feel it was created to honor them. Replicant's first appearance is one big love letter to the Rogues Gallery. This was also before they had truly been established as the badasses they are now. At the time, the classic Barry Allen foes still carried a bit of a stigma as goofy Silver Age characters. That would change just a few months later though, when Geoff Johns started his run on the title. This doesn't really apply to Abracadabra though. It's not even say he was in his prime in the 1990s. But then again, he never did belong with the Rogues. Like Professor Zoom and Gorilla Grodd, he was a separate entity. Anyway, that's neither here nor there. If you love the classic Flash Rogues, you would probably love this guy's origin story. It's all about them, really. Tony himself is not a bad character either, but his mimic powers does really limit him. Like I said, these types of characters never last. And it is a bit of a shame in this case, as Replicant's origin is so good. And he does have a pretty damn cool design, too. His story does feel a bit unfinished. We needed some more closure to the tale of Anthony Gambi. Like maybe, for instance, him sacrificing himself for the Rogues. They could then have made a sort of martyr out of him, a legend among the Rogues, a story passed on throughout the generations. That never happened though, and it's too late now, so let's just forget the whole thing, okay? Anyway, as always, remember, Arkham Asylum awaits you in the next video.